I really lost it there at the end, didn't I? Right at the very end, bro. Right at the very end. Weak and powerless. The guitar tone is really hard to get. My Flamma Banana came in handy. Alright, so my guitar tone here for A Perfect Circle, or Weak and Powerless by A Perfect Circle, I took my clean tone that, if you've been watching, you know that I stole this from one of the patches that already existed in the HX Stomp. I didn't even change the name of it, so that's what it's called, and I just changed a little bit of it. We can go through it real fast. Let's see what all I have on. Okay. So, starting with the amp, here is my settings. I had to turn up the drive for this. Normally my drive is much lower, but to get that nice little, you know, there's some good fuzz going on in this song. So to get that going, I had to turn up the drive, and that still wasn't enough. I had to use this external overdrive pedal that I have here. I just couldn't find a good one in the HX Stomp, and it just so happened that the one I have here sounded perfect with it. I will add it here. I'll take a picture of it and add it here if I can. I'll put a picture of the Flamma Banana somewhere around there. Hopefully it'll pop up right there. Right there. I got that off of Amazon, I think, for like $25 or something, and it's amazing. I bought this here Friedman small box to try to use, and I guess it's a very particular tone, but it's the Flamma Banana that I had on this side was so much more versatile than the Friedman small box that I just, if you're looking for an overdrive pedal, this little Flamma Banana is amazing. I recommend to anybody. So anyway, back to here. I didn't really mess with anything here. I just turned up the drive some. And then I used the Flamma, like I was saying, to give it a little bit more overdrive. I was using this here, Dynamic Ambience reverb pedal. Just a little bit. Just to give it a little bit of a, you know, like some room noise. And then I had the mod phase, of course, the only one I ever use, turned down way low in the mix, so you could barely hear it. It was barely affecting the tone. But without it, I think it was really missing something. So at the end of it all, hold on, I also had this Kinky compressor. Ooh, this Kinky compressor on. I did dial in all of these settings. I just messed around with it a little bit until I got the amount of control and sustain that I wanted with still enough play. Where I could affect the volume, you know, but still if I wanted to like pick chords or something. You can still hear all those individual notes in there. Because I'm not very good at control with my right hand, so you know, I gotta do what I can. So we use a compressor instead. So all in all, it's a pretty simple tone. Here's my cabinet for anybody who's interested in that. I always forget about the cabinet, even though it makes such a difference. Here, let me just change this mic real fast so you guys can see the difference of what a mic makes, right? So, and then if I change that, just one over. So yeah, they're pretty different. You can also move them around in this, which I think is really cool. And it really changes the sound as well. If you change, you can even change the distance. I don't think this is a song that we need to go over like how to play it. It was pretty simple and it goes the whole time. Simple. It's the same pattern over and over again, but it's, you know, it's hard to play. But But anyway, this is what my tone sounded like without any of the backtrack. So anyways, I'll leave you with my amp settings here. I feel like those are probably the most important. Like I said, you're going to need to add a little bit extra to that. For that, I had tried this here distortion pedal, but it was a little bit much. It was a little too much. It was a little too much for the intro section where he picks it slower or softer and it makes a... Less, you know, he's got one of those amps where the harder you pick it, the more distortion that it gets. So that's pretty cool. But you could probably play with this one. This hair apparent. Her apparent? Hair. Air. Air apparent. There you go. You could probably play with this one and get it to sound pretty good, pretty close. With just this distortion pedal here. But like I said, I just happen to have the Flamma Banana on my pedal board already, and when I turned it on, it just, I like the sound of it, so I just kept that going. There's the amp again. The, like I said, the mod phase was really turned down. If you listen closely, let's take a listen. I feel like you can hear a little bit of whooshing going on. There's also some palm muting that I can hear in the song. So there's definitely some palm muting that goes on in the song. Very, very, very light palm muting. As much as I like the song, it's not a guitar part that I feel is complex enough or even really all that cool enough for me to want to go and learn it exactly the way it is. So, it is what it is. Thanks for watching.